Hello, I'm Laura Cat, and I just wanted to have you guys join me today. Hopefully you can watch this sometime around Christmas, or later is fine too. It's Christmas time 2020. We all know it's been a pretty hard year with isolation and all that stuff, so I wanted to do a few videos, hopefully, about Upsidedown Cat, and yes, it's Casio music, but it's also kind of my life, and there's different things that I have been doing the last 10 years since I did my music. So today I'm going to talk about printmaking, which is a pretty big part of Upsidedown Cat. It's always kind of come alongside the music, and so we'll get into that and lots of stuff. But first I want to show you my sweater, Scotty and Westy puppy dog sweater. I know there might be a cat sweater in a different episode, so, welcome. And then I also want to show you a music box because it's Christmassy. And yeah, it's a present, obviously. And then I want to show you a mug, and I hope you can see this well. It's a kitty in a sweater, and then it also says you're perfect. Because you are, and I know, like I said, it's been a hard year. Luckily, back in January, I got in touch with my good friend Todd, and he kind of helped Upsidedown Cat even happen. He was my songwriting teacher, and so that just kind of started even before the isolation and COVID stuff. I was already reflecting on my music over the last 10 years, and thinking about doing more music. I have two young kids, so it's kind of hard to fit that in, but it is slowly happening. So let me see. I'll share more on the songwriting in a different video, hopefully, but today I want to show printmaking stuff because that's another thing I picked back up this year. So, let's see. There's all sorts of kinds of printmaking. You can research that in your own time. I'm just gonna quickly go over a few things. This is my cat, and this is it's an etching, but it's also kind of a dry point, which is a certain technique where you scrape onto a copper plate. Like I said, there's a lot of information I could give, but we're gonna go kind of quick. Here's a copper plate. I hope you can see that. Okay. This is my bus number 44 print, based on that song that you may know if you're a fan. And so that's the plate, and you etch it in acid. You can learn more about that later too. But here's the finished picture. Hope you can see that. So, obviously, that's me. That's my Casio MT45, which is the original and only real Casio, even though I've had other Casios and I do have some right now. Here's the lion hanging out with the clouds. And this is my bus stop. There's Mount Hood and there's Portland, I guess. And there's Orion. And it was a really fun print to do, and I was at PCC in community college and just learning about how to get drawings and ideas onto paper with printmaking. So, ta-da! But I should backtrack a little bit. Before that, my grandpa gave me a brayer. This is called a brayer. It's what you use to roll ink onto stuff. So he gave this to me, and also some old ink, and almost like a tile, like a floor tile, probably linoleum or whatever, to roll the ink out on. So he used to do leaf prints. He would roll ink and print leaves on paper. And so when I was a kid, he gave that stuff to me, I guess just passing it on. So that's kind of just interesting that, you know, I had some of the supplies, and then later in school, I learned more about printmaking. So, in high school, I did this little kitty cat, and I was really into photography. I loved space. I guess this is just texture, And then I would always wear the shirts with, like, the long sleeve shirt and short sleeve shirt. And I was an environmentalist and a cat. So this is one of the very first, like, even before the music happened, this is a Upsidedown Cat. You probably recognize that cat. So printmaking's awesome. In college, I continued with it. And this is a screen print. And it's announcing my graduation from Portland State. Pretty cool. And then, let's see, I've got a list of stuff. I'm trying to make sure I don't miss everything. Okay, yeah, I just want to say that, you know, obviously I haven't done music for almost 10 years. That's kind of hard when there's, like, a part of you that feels like an essential part of you, and then you take a really long break, and then it's usually not intentional, or at least it wasn't really intentional for me. Just stuff happened, and then I started having kids and work and commuting, and there's just hard to have time. So just a reminder to, like, try to remember who you are, and even if you can do something for, like, 5 or 10 minutes a day, creative, even if you're a busy mom like me, it really does help kind of connect that part of you back in. And I know this year, like, it's part of the time I haven't even felt like being productive. Some days you're just surviving. Some days you're just, like, you know, trying to maintain sanity. So it's not like I did a bunch of stuff this year. I did a few things, and so I will show them. But this is just kind of, yeah, over the history of Upsidedown Cat. So, like, 10 or plus years of printmaking. Let's see. Oh, okay. So, yeah, I like printmaking because it's something I can do at home with limited supplies. And it's not, like, super expensive. I guess it could be if I did it a lot. But, you know, it's just something you can do. I also like because it goes on fabric and paper. And since I do fabric-y things too, it's awesome. You can make band shirts or whatever. And I also like that it's multiples. And so you can pass them out to people or, like, Christmas cards. It's pretty fun. You can do that too if you want. It's just a very, like, versatile craft versus, like, painting one painting and being like, I painted this one painting that can only be in one person's house unless I, like, you know, make prints of it and sell them as postcards or something, which is also, you know, awesome. But I like printmaking because I can pass it out. So, the other thing is you might know about Sound Ghost. My husband has Sound Ghost Studios, and through that is also Sound Ghost Musical Collective, which is a group of our friends that's varied and shifted over the years, but we still sort of exist. And so part of that, I feel like my role sort of is making art for some of the bands that have come through. And original goal was to do, like, CD covers and stuff or album covers. I've done a little tiny bit of that. I guess I've done my album covers, which I'll show in a minute. But yeah, it's just fun to, like, have inspiration to make stuff for other people. There's actually, I'll show you this. There's a band that we've only done one song and it was a long time ago, but, I think it's Cat versus Bear, except I made it Bear versus Cat, but I'm pretty sure it's Cat versus Bear. It's me, Upsidedown Cat, and then Chris Bruhn is the bear, and then Mike is in the band Bruhn. So it's all of us, I guess. It's a cassette cover, so you'd fold it and glue it into a cassette tape cover. So this is for our future cassette tape. And yes, I made this 10 years ago because I know someday it's gonna happen. It's a screen print. 1, 2, 3, 4 color screen print. And then this orange is actually a block print. I'm not sure why I did that, but I did. So yeah, it's just something, like, you know, it may not happen this year, but one of these days it will happen. And then another Sound Ghost thing I have is, this is a block, it's going to be hard to see, but that's the print. It's a little Christmas thing, I guess. Oh, it says on the back, I did this in 2009. I did 70 copies. It's only one color, so that makes it easier to print. I'll tell you more about that later. That's just a fun Christmassy thing I found. And it's kind of fun. I've hung on to a lot of blocks, so you'll see some today. Speaking of the band Bruhn, here's their CD. Pull from this end. I made t-shirts for them, you know, maybe not 10 years ago, but a while back. And then I've also made other t-shirts. Like, I made my awesome A's for accordion shirt. That's a screen print, too. And then I turned it into this weird, it's kind of a dish towel with other shirts that I cut up. So, but I'll show you, here's the screen. We won't get into screen printing too much today. And you can always watch YouTube videos, but that's the screen. This one's hand-painted onto, it's called a silk screen. And then maybe you can see, wherever you can see through is where the ink would go. And you use a squeegee to pull it across the frame. You're probably maybe a little familiar with that. But again, screen printing is awesome because t-shirts, you can make quilt fabric, paper, whatever, posters, all that stuff. So now we're at this year, 2020, which is a weird year, obviously. Didn't know all that was gonna happen. I'm gonna do some other videos, I hope. I wanted to talk about, songwriting, and then also I might talk about my faith a little bit. And back in January, I picked joy as a topic for this year, and I didn't know that the pandemic was gonna happen, and like all the wildfires and all that stuff. I didn't know that all that was gonna happen, and that I would have anxiety and maybe some like mild depression or whatever. So it's just interesting how things happen, and so we'll get to that more later, hopefully. But I want to share this guy. This is a cassette tape I did, just a few of them. I think it's 2008. I'm not sure. These are 20-minute cassette tapes. Oh yeah, it says August 2008. That's cool. I hope you can see this well enough. So it's got some weird demos on it that I found. Like a French version of the Hooray song, which is the kitty cat song. A song I played on guitar, which I'm not good at guitar. It's got some Fruity Loop stuff. And then also Fruity Loops is a like a looping program, which I did some demos and stuff on. If you go to my SoundClick page, which I'll give you info later, there's some demos on there and you can hear what it's like. And also some of the like Kitty Ludes on the Soon Fall Will Be Here album. A lot of that's Fruity Loop, like the electronic-y sounding stuff, just in case you didn't know. This also has a couple stories from the 90s when my sister and I recorded our TV show in our living room, or sorry, radio show. It was called the Red Couch Talk Show, and so it has like stories I was doing, so yeah, that's fun. So I don't know, basically I made more covers this year because I realized some people didn't have them. So here's my block, hope you can see that. And here's this little bear, and the bear's actually, it was from, like, I think my friend brought it back from Japan, or, yeah, it's, so it was already, like, pre-drawn, and you just carve it yourself, which is really cool, and so I was able, since I had these blocks, I was able to make more covers this year, and, I have a few of them. I'm not really, like, selling a lot of merch right now, but if you're, like, really dying have one, please let me know, and I can probably make you one and mail it sometime after the holiday craziness is over. So yeah, so that brought out my printmaking stuff this year, which was kind of cool. Let's see, I'm just reading my notes. I'm gonna show my Upsidedown Cat cover. Hopefully you've heard this album. It's great. not to, like, you know, be prideful, but I do think this is a cool CD that happened 10 years ago. So there's that. It's four colors of prints. I bought blank, this like chipboard stuff. I brought blank ones and printed them myself on spring break in 2010. And, that was when I was at PSU and had access to all their printmaking stuff. And, you know, sometimes things line up well, sometimes they don't. So I think we did like 250 copies, and I'm basically out of good copies. So a few years ago, my husband made this, which is just like a scanned version of it. And we kind of compiled it. But, you know, it's just like a really thin thing to put the CD in. So I really wanted to get back to a hand-done cover because it is so, like, Upsidedown Cat to have handmade stuff. So I'm working on a design. This is one color, and that's another color, and they would go on top. I hope you can kind of see that. and I might even like have to handwrite the Upsidedown Cat part, but that's okay. So, it would just be two colors, which would be a lot easier to print, easier to line up, faster to do. And then, just a simple like pocket design, just where the CD goes in and the liner notes and stuff, because I do want to sell real CDs again. Every once in a while someone buys my CD and they find out about me, and it's so awesome, and it's great to have fans around the world. And I love fan mail. Thank you guys for sending it when you do. It really encourages me to someday actually get back to the music part of life. And then I also want to show this because it's winter time. This is the Christmas CD. It's winter 2010 again. Hopefully you've heard this. It's on Bandcamp. I'll give you information in a second. And then this was just a Christmas present my husband and I threw together. Actually, we weren't married yet, but we were like destined to get married, I guess. So we threw that together in about 2 weeks with the help of Jonathan, our friend, and the Fatals. And yeah, so that was awesome. And I wanted to show, I'll show more in a second, but it's based on this, if you can see that. It's basically the reverse of that and the same star, or snowflake, I guess. So that's kind of cool. It's based on a block print, which I'll show you in a bit. But first, I was going to, I'm not sure why I did it in this order, but that's okay. So I talked about Sound Ghost Musical Collective. And I was going to share another print I made. Oops, I gotta go get it. Well, okay. This is funny. I was going to share about Sound Ghost Musical Collective. And this year, what's kind of happened in it. We have our friends, Chris and Caleb, and they're in a band, Dr. Wattley. And you can listen to it if you want to. And it's been inspiring to me because they're some of the friends we've, like, let in our house this year, sporadically throughout the pandemic or whatever. It's a long-term project, which encourages me to keep doing Upsidedown Cat. They've let me sing on a couple songs, which is cool because I don't sing a whole lot anymore, so that was fun to be invited to sing. And also just the collective is more like, I feel like, coming back and, so it's just helpful to have creative friends if you're a creative person or whoever, because I feel like you do feed off that stuff and just collaborating and ideas, and it's just helpful to have feedback and just more people to kind of not share the work, but, you know, just like keep on going, like keep on rolling and stuff. So I made a block for them. Because I wanted to do a block for Halloween, sort of, gearing up towards my Christmas print, which I'll show you in a little bit. But they've got this skull, which I guess is important to them. I don't know the whole story, but they were talking about band shirts, and I just, in my head, was like, I want to see what this looks like as a block print, just with the style of all that. So I carved it out, and I did it really quick in about, like, 2 hours and printed it that night, because it's just one color, and it turned out great, and I was just reminded, like, how easy it is, if I don't overthink stuff, to just, like, do it, and if I have the time, if the kids are asleep or whatever, I can do it. And it was just really exciting to have a project turn out so quickly, and gave me hope for my Christmas print, which I'll show you. So this is on fabric. That's this is like a patch for, like, it could be a band shirt if someday it will be made. And then I do have a paper print of it, but I have to go get it, and I don't know if I'll mess up the camera. So hang on 1 second. Talk amongst yourselves. Okay. So here's the print. Yeah, so I don't know how to describe it. I guess it's rock. It's kind of weird. You can find them on Bandcamp under Dr. Wattley, and they also have a YouTube. And like I said, it's a long-term project, so some of the songs were written a long time ago. So that's I don't know, never mind. But yeah, it's been inspiring to Mike and I, because just having new energy, I guess, and like working on stuff over the last year with other projects, so makes us want to work on our projects more, is what I'm trying to say. And yeah, now I'm gonna show some Christmas prints over the year, because doing that skull print, I was like, sweet, I can do this. Now I have hope for doing my Christmas print. But if you don't know, there's been other Christmas prints in other years. So this is 2005. This is the very first Christmas print. Probably the second kitty cat print after this guy. So yeah, just one color, really easy, pretty fun. And the thing about printmaking, like this style, is you have to do it all backwards. So you can see my letters are a little shaky, but I was drawing it and carving it all backwards. And then that was 2005, 2007, which is this guy. And, you know, which I said inspired this, and also kind of part of it's in my print this year too. I'll show you later. This one's 2008. And so I don't know how to explain it, I guess, but, basically, you print one color first. So I printed red, and then I carve away whatever I want to stay red. Like, here's the scarf. I carved away all that scarf area, and then printed black on top. Whoops. And so, yeah, there's my snowman kitty cat thing. And I think, honestly, I mean, it might even be that same mountain. I do kind of occasionally reuse things because, you know, just keeping in the same theme of stuff. So I'll show you, this as the back of it. I often reuse blocks. And so that was a thank you kitty cat block I did. And then I love this one. This is 2009, one of my most favorite maybe. I like that it's tiny. I like that it has the, like, Jesus star in it, and just, like, a winter scene. I remember passing them out at my job at Portland State Library, and people were just like, oh, cool, because everyone who works at a library likes cats, right? So that one's really fun. I'm glad I still have that. I'm glad it's a one-color one, so I could print that again. And there's some that are missing. 2010... I don't know which one 2010 is. I think 2010 is a screen print, and I need to find it. It has icicles and stuff, and it has blue in it. This one is Joyous Noel, 2011, kitty cat. This is a linoleum block, so it's like a big, heavy block that you would put through a printing press usually. It's kind of hard to see this way, obviously, but, you know, it's kind of fun. Kind of Valentine's-y. I'm glad I have it. I actually have lots of copies. If anyone really wants one, I could probably mail it, but probably not until after the holidays. Because of the post office and all that. So that was 2011. Here's 2012. This was an idea, but obviously I didn't do that idea. I'm not sure where 2012 is. And then I wanted to show this one. I actually have the block is broken. And I only have, it's a reductive, so I had already cut away the first color. So somewhere in my craft room, which is a super big mess, I'm sure I have a print of it. But I wanted to at least have something to share, because it references this year's print, too. So, this is 2013, when I got married. Obviously, we're in love. And then, he's giving her a present, which is a dead fish, which is funny to me. So, yeah, I'll find the print someday and share it somewhere. Or it might even be on Facebook, buried. I don't know. It's so hard to find everything when you want it. So that's 2013. I don't know about 2014. That's a mystery too. It's around here somewhere or never happened. This was an idea I had for 2015, but I decided to go with something else. We bought our house in 2015, which was crazy because we were trying to find room for a recording studio and a craft room and stuff. So we've got a huge fireplace in our living room, which is good because it's not in the studio, it's in the living room. So here's a bear, which is kind of fun. And then I made a house, it's like a birdhouse, I guess, but I painted it and stuff for my husband when we were house hunting for like 8 months, because I wasn't sure if we'd have a house for Christmas. So I made him a little Christmas house. Maybe that'll show up in a different episode here. And again, with the red and black theme, which you'll see continues. So 2016 is, I like this one a lot. I always do the like sweaters and stuff. And since I'm a knitter, you know, it's easy to want to make little sweaters for animals. This one's really fun. I like square stuff too. And sometimes it's easier to print if it's square and not such a big block. So then, 2017, I had a child, and then after that I had another child. So we're gonna jump to 2020 because it's the first year I've done a block for Christmas. So, and then like I think I said, I chose joy this year as a focus, and that's really helped me. I've got some like quotes on the walls and Bible verses and stuff, and you know, I read them even if I don't feel like it, and it does help. And just kind of having an eye out for it. And joy, to me, it's not just happiness. It's like, I guess what people would call the biblical version of joy, where like even when there's hard things going on, you can still have joy amongst the struggles and stuff. And it's more than just being happy. It's just like getting past all the darkness and everything and maintaining some sort of joy. So, you'll notice, look at that little snowflake. I kind of copied that into this year too, just because it's cool. And where's my penguins? The penguin family has grown. And obviously I didn't really have this one to reference, but I think it turned out all right, and that, you know, it seems like they're from the same realm, I guess. So, I wanted to show the block. It is reductive where you cut away to get that second color. So I've cut away all the spots I wanted to keep red. It probably helps if I show this off again. So, and it's backwards, you know, when you print it, it's in the reverse. So yeah, it was kind of a weird block to ink, and it's always hard to line stuff up. So they don't all look like this. I got a pretty good amount of good ones, but I also got some fun mess-ups, and sometimes the mess-ups are awesome, too. You know, it's kind of like 3D looking, so I don't know that I'll mail this to anyone, but I'll keep a few of them just because it's fun, and usually I keep almost everything, so maybe some year someone will be like, cool, I got the messed up Upside Down Cat 2020 print. So, and then I was going to show, I wish I had these in two colors, but here's the first color I was test printing just to see if my block looked good when I very first did it. And I thought, yeah, that looks pretty good. I don't have to carve any more out. And then the second print, which is the, it's hard to describe it. It's all in layers, so you kind of have to think in layers as a printmaker, which is weird. But this is basically that one. So if that makes sense to you and makes you happy, I'm so glad. Let's see. What else can I talk about? Yeah, I'm hoping to do more videos. I already said that. Oh, I was going to tell you where to find me. So my Casio songs are on Bandcamp under Upsidedown Cat. It's Upsidedown, all one word, and then cat. And then SoundClick, also Upsidedown Cat. That has more of the demos, weird stuff, some improv songs. I'm on Instagram as Upsidedown Cat Knits, all one word. I do lots of knitting and sewing, and that's kind of what I've done more as crafting for the last bit. I do have a website that's kind of focused on the crafting stuff. It's pretendlikeyoureknitting.weebly.com. It's got some knitting, sewing, quilting, hand-bound books that I've made, refrigerator pictures, and some other weird projects. So I updated it more like at the beginning, like in June when the lockdown and stuff was happening. I was working on updating that, but it's not updated all the time, but there is a lot of stuff going on. It's just not all music. And again, hopefully I'll do another video and talk about songwriting in that. And yeah, so just want to say that repetitive crafts can be soothing. And whether it's printmaking or sewing or knitting or whittling, or like, there's so many, you know, maybe it's a good time to pick up a new craft. And just so I hope you guys have a really good Christmas and take care, and just remember to reach out, and we're not alone. It might feel like we're very, very, very alone and very sad, but we're not alone. And yeah, so have a great day. And Merry Christmas! Yay! Bye.